nearly a decade, the Ford Mustang had the market on budget blacktop scorching cornered. No real competition helps, but that didn't stop Ford from keeping the heat on with one special edition after another. Enter the 2008 Mustang Bullitt. It's one of the best versions yet of the current Mustang, thanks to a new cold air intake system, less restrictive exhaust, tweaked electronics, and a tough look. But just as the Mustang is getting cozy in our retro-loving hearts, the 2008 Dodge Challenger SRT8 shows up, kicking plenty of sand and tire smoke in its face. It may be the new kid on the block, but the Challenger's 6.1-liter V8 gives Mustang lovers every reason to be afraid. True, the Bullitt has Hollywood and pony car history on its side, but the Challenger needs just one word to dominate the conversation. Hemi. The Bullitt counters with a potent V8 and hair-raising exhaust note of its own. The 4.6-liter engine's red line has been extended to 6,500 versus the GT, and output is now 315 horsepower. That doesn't sound like much compared to the Hemi, but the Mustang has a manual transmission and is 600 pounds lighter. Both the Challenger and Mustang were raised on a steady diet of drag racing and lead footing, so there's no better way to find the true king of the hill than an old-fashioned grudge match. The Bullitt is easy to launch and cover the quarter mile in 13.7 seconds at 103 miles per hour. Impressive for any streetcar. 0 to 60 comes up in 5.4 seconds. Through the slalom, the lighter Mustang felt alert and nimble, but the solid rear axle hurt its speed in the end. Pavement irregularities also make the Bullitt more of a handful. It crossed the finish line at 66.1 miles per hour. And this is where it all goes horribly wrong for the Mustang. Even though the Challenger SRT8 is bigger, heavier, and doesn't offer a manual transmission, there's just no way around 425 snarling horsepower and 420 pound-feet of torque. At 13.2 seconds, the Challenger is quicker in the quarter mile by half a second. Its 107.5 mile per hour trap speed also means it's almost 5 miles per hour faster. As far as drag races go, that's a decisive victory. The Challenger's size hurt it in the slalom, but ultimately the immense grip of the optional Goodyear Eagle F1 tires and the quick steering helped produce a 66.2 mile per hour pass, a tenth quicker than the Mustang, and a remarkable feat for any 2-ton automobile. Take the SRT8 Challenger away from the track and the story isn't much different. Despite its 20-inch wheels and SRT-tuned suspension, the Dodge is the more comfortable car and is perfectly at home on the highway. The Challenger's interior is also better. It has useful back seats, plus all the switches and buttons in the Challenger feel substantial. There are audio, trip computer, and vehicle status buttons on the steering wheel, while the Bullitt has just cruise control. But good things usually cost more, so the Challenger is more expensive by $5,400. Budget-minded muscle car shoppers will surely see the Bullitt Mustang as the winner here, but the Dodge Challenger SRT8's decisive combination of civility and brute strength make it well worth the extra cash.